It's been a dramatic day for passengers and crew on board a Qantas flight from Auckland after the pilot was forced to issue a rare Mayday call. Dozens of emergency crews prepared for the worst, crowding the runway at Sydney Airport, where the plane eventually touched down safely. Leah Harris is there for us. Leah, what went wrong?
Well, Ashley, halfway through the journey here to Sydney, the plane's left engine failed. The pilot managed to continue the flight using just one engine. There were 145 passengers on board and they all disembarked safely here this afternoon, feeling understandably very relieved. An emotional reunion after a close call.
Thank God we're here. We thanked the captain profusely.
Families waited anxiously on the ground.
I was on the way to the airport when the news broke, so it was a bit of a worry, but all good.
While their loved ones in the air were none the wiser.
We didn't know till we landed.
Oh, you didn't know till you were landed was an engine problem?
No.
The Qantas flight QF144 left Auckland about 2 p.m. on its way to Sydney. Halfway through the journey, the pilot issued a rare Mayday call after the left engine on the Boeing 737 failed.
We didn't realise it was actually the whole engine had gone. I mean, we just heard a bang and that was it.
The Mayday triggered a level 2 alert response from emergency crews on the ground, prompting at least 30 police crews, 20 ambulances and 12 fire trucks to race to the airport ready for landing. Around 3:30 p.m. the plane touched down safely, with one engine still working. Qantas says that while a Mayday was initially issued, this was downgraded to possible assistance needed. While in-flight engine shutdowns are rare, our pilots are trained to manage them safely and aircraft are designed to fly for an extended period on one engine.
My wife had called about, 18 times. Have you landed? Have you landed?
The first call here this evening would be delightful.
It's not the first near miss for Qantas. In 2010, a Qantas flight took off from Singapore headed for Sydney when it suffered engine failure. Today's incident comes just weeks after Qantas reclaimed its place at the top of the list for the world's safest airline. Engineers are still investigating what caused the problem this time around. Leah Harris, ABC News, Sydney.